Aw, look at the cute little panda. Isn't he adorable? And sometimes annoying! How can something like that be annoying? Why, every time he comes out the box, I never know what he's gonna do to me. Is he gonna let me win, or is he gonna let me lose? Now, Takenoko is a family-style game, and as a family, we play it quite regularly. And what annoys me is the fact that sometimes when we play as a family, my daughter will win. And that annoys me. And that sounds nasty and that sounds wrong. I know, I know. But she has this strategy of picking up the panda cards all the time and then filling up the orders on these panda cards. And sometimes she wins. Not all the time, but sometimes. Which leads me to think of three questions. One. Has this game not been playtested enough so balancing issues with scoring are a bit out the window? Two, is this game just a luck fest of dice rolling and card pulling? Three, is my daughter really, really intelligent beyond her years? And four, am I just really bad at playing games and dumb as plums? Takenoko is not the only game that leaves me hiding under the table. Steam Park as well. It has this idea of a family game with a bit of strategy, but it doesn't feel like there's any strategy, it just feels like luck. My daughter will sometimes win with her one strategy, which is buy pink and black rides, because they're monster high colours, and then just play a card every turn to earn two or three money. Ah! Our board game's being deliberately designed that doesn't matter what your level of skill is, you've got a good chance of winning. Is this a good thing? Is this a bad thing? What do you think?